Hello and welcome to this week's edition of Inside Bronco Football. I'm Bob Beeler. Even though we're a number of days removed from the Nevada game, you still need to kind of catch your breath and say, wow, that was a dramatic 51-46 win by the Broncos and a pretty good way to enter Boise State's first bye week of the season. Here's our Tucano's Brazilian Grill menu for this week's show. We'll dissect last week's win from start to finish with Coach Harsin. It was hard to identify just one drive that made this game, so we'll look at a couple of key drives in the game. And quarterback Grant Hedrick stops by our Inside Bronco football set to talk about the season to the midway point this year.
Tonight, execution, pure execution, running downhill, punishing people.
I only been here for 2 years, but I know this game is way more than what we played tonight. This game is for them who played last year, the year before that. This game is more than us right here. So I know that we need to eat tonight. We're going to make Bronco Nation proud, and we're going to come home with a dub. Let's go. Let's go. Eat up on three. One, two, three. Eat up.
The emotion for the early season showdown was sky high, no question. You could feel it in the sold-out Reno crowd, in the several thousand Bronco fans who traveled, and without a doubt on the field between both of the teams. Our Inside Bronco football crew takes us field level for the first half St. Luke's game highlights.
Third downs defensively make Boise State one-dimensional. On third and 10, Hedrick scrambling, looking, throwing, man open, fires the catch, and he's got it. Broncos have had to adjust their defense. Fajardo rolling and throwing. It's picked up. Thompson inside Boise State's first score. Clock under 2.5 minutes left. First half. Fajardo, deep middle. That's picked up. Did he? Fajardo in trouble. A huge loss back at the 50. That's a 20-yard loss. Motion. Option the inside pitch. Touchdown, Boise State. Jake Rowe with a great blocking performance. Quick throw, Williams Rhodes. And he's in. Touchdown, Boise State. 31. Hedrick has time to the sidelines. Gorgeous pass. Caught there. Thomas Spurbeck. Let's see what the Broncos do with it on first and 10. Hedrick, big play, goes deep, and it's caught at the 5. From the 45, little toss inside Jeremy McNichols. Second and goal. Hedrick keeps it to the end zone. Touchdown, Boise State.
As you saw in those highlights, it was a back-and-forth first half, where Boise State stole the momentum in the final 4 minutes of the second quarter. In the first part of our Coach Harsin one-on-one conversation, we discussed the emotion and momentum swings from the first half. Coach, this week heading into the Nevada game, what did it seem like leading up to the game? Because it seemed like to me there was a lot on the line, there'd be a lot of intensity for it.
The big emphasis this week was we're going to practice and we're going to play the same way. So let's go out there and take advantage of these 3 days of practice and really have a great week. And, you know, the players, coaches, everybody did that. We've kind of built that emotion leading into this game, and Nevada's an emotional game.
After last week's struggles on offense, to score three out of the first 4 times you have the ball against Nevada had to be huge to get off to a good start.
Yeah, it's good for us. You know, I mean, take Nevada out of it. You know, that's really what we wanted to do, come out there and really prove to ourselves we can take care of the football. We can go down there and score. Bring Nevada back into it. They were the best in the league, you know, in red zone defense. So once we got down there, that was a huge challenge for us. You know, we need to put points on the board. We figured they would score. You know, we thought that their offense and the way their quarterback was playing, they're going to put points up. We needed to answer with points of our own.
Talk about Grant's play. I mean, he had a rough game against Air Force, and I thought came back and was just almost unstoppable, especially in the first half. But what kind of a performance he had and what you thought he did?
Good. You know, I really do. I mean, I think... you know, you go back to the last week's game you know, you think that he's not going to be the quarterback, and that's not the case. You know, we never even flinched on that. And it's just a matter of executing the plays a little bit better. You know, it really wasn't much different than Air Force, how we prepped, the type of plays we ran, we executed them better. And so when you do that and guys around him do the same things, you see the confidence. You know, and Grant's a good quarterback. He's proven that. Came out of this game with a very high QB rating. And so it was good to see him come back out there and just perform better in the way that he knows how he can perform.
There was a stretch in the first half where both teams were scoring back and forth. Nevada got the ball back. They were ahead by five, had a chance to do something, and then Tyler Gray made a pretty big play.
Yeah, the Gray interception was huge. That was, you know, if you go back and actually watch the tape, he's actually the backside linebacker and gets clear over there from the backside to get this interception on a little stick route. But to turn it into points, you know, that's one thing on the defensive side. It doesn't matter how we score, we can get points, and we've done that a couple times this year. It was huge, and that momentum change put us back into the lead right there in that situation.
And then following it right up with a Dante Dion interception, then you guys decided to go right for the throat on the next play.
Yeah, so we got another pick, you know, a sudden change opportunity, and you know, in that type of situation there, you got a couple options. You want to just go drive it out and kind of grind it or take a shot. Felt like we had a place set up, and we're on the right hash to do that, and it was time. And, you know, Chaz made a great catch in that play. Grant threw it up. Chaz went and got it. You know, I thought we scored right there, but we were down there on the, you know, two-yard line or something like that when it was all said and done.
Boise State's defense forced three first-half turnovers, and we're oh so close to a couple of more. Kamale Correa lowers the boom in our Nampa Floors and Interiors hit of the game, forcing the fumble.
Speaking of knocked out, loose ball, Boise State has it if it's a catch.
That's how you time it up for Kamale Correa.
High drama was the best way to describe the second half of the game. We'll break that down in our next segment here on Inside Bronco Football, giving you sights and sounds you can only find here.
We've been serving Idaho for generations, offering fresh, quality foods at great prices and raising premium Northwest beef. Today, we're proud to announce that Double R Ranch 100% USDA Choice Beef is exclusively available at your local Albertsons. Just like our founders, Joe Albertson and Robert Rebholz Sr., we truly believe in quality, tradition, and supporting our neighbors. Double R Ranch, exclusively available at Albertsons.
Color Us Proud. Lithia Ford of Boise, an official sponsor of Boise State Athletics. Lithia, where Ford begins in Idaho.
I was on my way home after a long day of nanny when my car went kaput, dead as a doornail, right in front of someone's driveway. So I thought I'd look for help, and wouldn't you believe it? The guy answers like a shining beacon of light.
Oh, sorry. I manage a Les Schwab here in town. I'd be happy to take a look.
Within 10 minutes, I had a new battery cable and was whistling on my way home. He wouldn't take any money, but I think I'll bake him some cookies. I'm Hillary Plock, and that's my Les Schwab story.
Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Anybody else think Coke seems to taste pretty great at McDonald's? Well, join the club. Is it because any size Coke is only a dollar? Or because fries and a Coke really hit the spot? Whatever it is, when any size Coca-Cola, soft drink, or sweet tea is just a buck, there's something for everyone to love at McDonald's.
at Subway Restaurants, we're gearing up for big wins from your Boise State Broncos. Celebrate every down at Subway with the Broncos meal, featuring your favorite Subway sandwich, chips, and a limited edition 30-ounce Broncos Collector's Cup. This is a season you won't want to miss with the Broncos' new head coach and 15 returning starters. Join the Broncos Nation today at Subway and show off your Boise State pride with a one-of-a-kind Collector's Cup, but only at your local Subway restaurant. Subway, where winners eat.
Let's set the scene. Boise State is up 41-26 to start the fourth quarter with the ball and controlling momentum. A tip ball and an interception return for TD by Nevada changes the landscape of the game. Enter Jay Ajayi. Our Lithia Ford drive of the game zeroes in on the Bronco answer to that Nevada defensive score. On the first play from the Boise State 21-yard line, Jay Ajayi uses the entire field, showing vision, strength, and speed to nearly take it the distance, running 74 yards to the Nevada 5-yard line. One play later, Ajayi bounces to the outside, taking it in for a 2-yard score. It pushed the Bronco lead to 51-36, providing a 2-score cushion that proved to be too much for Nevada to overcome. Ajayi ran for 116 yards and 3 scores in the second half, displaying his full arsenal. The highlights were many in the second half as we take you back to Mackey Stadium with our St. Luke's game highlights.
No interceptions. Ajayi bounces it outside. He's 20. He's 10. Ajayi to the corner. He's in. Touchdown. 26 yards. Fajardo.
Close game on the road, 1 week after suffering a tough loss. How would the Broncos respond? We go one-on-one with Coach Harsin again to discuss the crazy second half and the drama that ensued. All right, we go to the locker room. It's 30-21 after those big plays late in the second quarter. How are you feeling, and what did you tell the team at halftime?
At that point, still feeling like we got 2 quarters left, you know, to be honest with you. The one thing we talked about going into this week is we've been in games, you know, against teams that maybe we should beat. We've been in games and teams we shouldn't beat, you know, and we've gone back and forth in both. And just reminded those guys, be consistent. Just be consistent. Now, hey, the first half's done. All right, don't worry about what went on there. Let's go out there and play the second quarter, or excuse me, the third and fourth quarter, the second half, better than we played the first half. We need to in order to win this game. So it wasn't really an emotional locker room at halftime. It was more of a focused locker room, like, hey, we still have a job to do and we need to finish.
What's the feeling on the sideline when you give up a couple of big plays that kind of let them get back in? You're up 2 scores, you're looking pretty good, and then they get the big long run, and then they get the batted ball in the air for an interception touchdown.
Yeah, that's just football. You know, I mean, those things happen. You got to be able to bounce back. You know, it's kind of an emotional punch. You know, that's part of toughness for us is, you know, you're going to take those emotional punches. How do you respond back, you know? And so they did make some plays. We knew that they were a good offense. We knew that they had, you know, a lot of firepower out there on the field.
One of those plays that got you back in the game was they had just scored, and Jay Ajayi goes 74 yards. He didn't get into the end zone on the play, but really set it up inside the five.
Yeah, we changed field position in a hurry on that play. And, you know, the O-line did a good job. You go back and watch it. You know, I mean, 3/4 of that play is Jay. He's just running around making guys miss. And, you know, really a big-time individual performance on that one particular play, and then we get down there and get ourselves in a position to score again. So those are big changes of field position. That's huge in this type of game. It's also momentum changes. Once they think they've got it, we get it right back, and, you know, that's what good teams do.
How difficult is it to defend somebody like Fajardo? Because he gives you a lot of problems running as well as passing. And
I thought all night he made good throws. They were accurate, threw on time. I thought he had some big time runs in that game. So we did just enough to kind of corral him. And I think the hits on him, the sacks and some plays where he was running the ball, I think those hits kind of add up, you know, as the game went on. So he made plays, but we made plays on him. It maybe didn't show up until later in the game when all of a sudden it got real tight and we had made more plays against him and we were able to stop him.
When the score was eight different down towards the end, you figure, okay, they're going to have to get a touchdown, they're going to have to get a two-point conversion. But all of a sudden they get a field goal, and it's now five. And your defense came up big the last two series.
Yeah. At the end of the game, you know, we had 3 minutes and 45 seconds left. We want to finish that on offense. We weren't able to do that. Their defense swelled up. We had to punt it, and then our defense has to go out there and get us really the win. And you know what? It's a great opportunity for the defense to go out there, especially in the way the game went. There were points, you know, on both sides, but the defense went out there and they had the last chance to really make a stand for our team, and they did it.
51-46 was the final score. Another epic game in the Nevada series. Here are the Milk victory keys to victory in the win. The Broncos relied on each other. Offense made plays to steal momentum before the half. And in the third quarter, the defense then rose up when it needed to, holding Nevada to 0 points in the final two drives with the game on the line. Boise State took hold in the red zone, converting on 6 of 6 opportunities, including 5 touchdowns. Sudden change made the difference. The Broncos converted 4 Wolfpack turnovers into 28 points, while Nevada managed just 10 points off 3 second-half Bronco turnovers as the defense stiffened when it needed to. More to come after this break as we'll sit down with senior quarterback Grant Hedrick at the midway point of the regular season. You're watching Inside Bronco Football presented by Ford.
It's here, Ford's Great American Tailgate Event, featuring America's best-selling brand. Introducing Ford Edge, Explorer, Escape, and the 2015 Ford Expedition. All powered by EcoBoost technology. Hurry in to Ford's Great American Tailgate Event. Now get up to $34.90 total savings or 0 for 60 plus up to $1,500 cash back. Or lease an Escape for just $209 a month. Only at your local Ford stores. Connection hot oven delivery truck. Every day it delivers hundreds of delicious Chicago Connection pizzas all over the valley. Hot, fresh from the oven pizzas with lots of delicious toppings served on a tummy pleasing crust and covered with heaps of real mozzarella cheese.
Ask for our money saving weekly special when you call or dine in. Chicago Connection. It's how you'll want your pizza.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot, man.
Happy to help.
There are all kinds of reasons to be glad you have AAA. Getting back on your way is just one of them. AAA. Keep life going.
Color Us Proud. Lithia Ford of Boise, an official sponsor of Boise State Athletics. Lithia, where Ford begins in Idaho.
Well, Welcome back to Inside Bronco Football. I'm Bob Beeler. No coach will argue that quarterback play is the most critical element to success of any football team. Fifth-year senior Grant Hedrick rebounded in a big way this past Saturday at Nevada, posting another strong outing to his 2014 campaign. Hedrick was ultra-efficient, completing 26 of 31 passes for 346 yards and two touchdowns, targeting nine different Bronco teammates in the process. He also ran for 40 yards and another score in amassing nearly 400 yards of total offense. Our Ford Bronco spotlight shines on Hedrick, the current Mountain West Conference leader in total offense. Senior leader on this team, how important was it to bounce back this week against Nevada, maybe in the style that you guys did it?
That was huge. I think, you know, just battling through the adversity we faced the week before and coming out and getting a win in an environment like that was big for our program.
Nevada came in as the top red zone defense. Red zone had been a little bit of a problem so far early in the season, but you guys played well in the red zone. What did you see and why was the team so successful 6-for-6 in the red zone this week?
Yeah, I think it's kind of a mindset. You get, you know, in the red zone, it's an attitude that we need to have. Go down there and just get points. You know, you get inside the 30 or 25, you know Dan's got a great leg, so we at least get three. So you got to take care of the ball down there, and obviously we want touchdowns.
Quarterback is a position that is scrutinized. If people are in the stands with binoculars, you're probably the position that's most focused on. What's it like doing that, and what's it like trying to come back from a tough game?
Yeah, it's awesome. It's a great opportunity to even, you know, put yourself in that spot to be scrutinized, and that's kind of how I see it. Not a lot of people get that opportunity to be, you know, in the spotlight. You know, you watch SportsCenter or ESPN on Sundays. I mean, they're talking about the quarterbacks, they're analyzing everything. And so to be in that position, it's awesome.
I know you want to keep everything kind of even, but wasn't it kind of fun to play a game like that where there's a lot of scoring and the officers going back down?
Oh, yeah, it was awesome. I've never been a part of a game like that, you know, where it's back and forth and a lot of emotions. And that was by far probably my most favorite win I've had, just in terms of you know, being up, being down, a lot of points scored, and you never know who's really going to come out, you know, at the end, the victor, because so many points were being scored.
We're down to our final timeout on Inside Bronco Football. As we head to break, we couldn't help but share with you the sights and sounds of the victory for Boise State and the emotion that comes with a huge road win.
Milk for us, first of all, it fuels Boise State. It's been a product for us that over years has shown to help our program and our team on the football field. What we're always trying to accomplish is get our guys back into the weight room and get them going and get them stronger and get them going harder. And if they're fueling their bodies and they're doing it the right way with the protein, the carbohydrates from milk, and we're giving it to them at the right time, then you are going to see the response and you're going to see those guys come back quicker.
Larry H. Miller dealerships are proud to sponsor the Bronco Nation of Boise State with thousands of vehicles to choose from, in person and online. Backed by one of the largest dealer groups in the nation, your local Larry H. Miller dealer is ready to help you score big. Because whether you're changing your oil or even your car, we're all about you. So gallop into one of our dealerships near you to see what a better auto experience is like when the focus is totally on you. Larry H. Miller dealerships, driven by you.
The best thing to check, Grandma, is macaroni cheese.
If you love macaroni and cheese, this is the place.
I love it.
Our recipe features three different types of cheeses. And also we put some special blends of seasonings in there.
Yummy, yummy.
and that creates our wonderful cheese sauce that makes this macaroni and cheese so special.
The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama.
Do you ever ask yourself, is my business prepared for benefit changes due to healthcare reform? Is my business carrying enough liability insurance? Or has my personal insurance coverage kept pace with my life? At Morton & Company, we help Idaho business owners insure their greatest assets. For help answering these questions and more, call 321-9300. Morton & Company. Innovation. Integrity. Insurance. Call 321-9300. Morton & Company. Trusted since 1910.
It's here. Ford's Great American Tailgate Event. Featuring America's best-selling brand. Leading the way. Ford Fusion. C-Max. Focus. And Escape. Winning starts here, so hurry into Ford's Great American Tailgate Event. Now get up to $3,500 cash back, or zero for 60, plus up to $1,500 cash back, or lease a Fusion for just $189 a month, only at your local Ford stores.
Boise State played six games in the first 37 days of the season. Talk about a good time for a bye week. Over the next 34 days, the Broncos will play just two games, and both at home, before a four-game November stretch run. You can see from this map the travel miles Boise State has logged in the first half of the season. 10,084 to be exact, with cross-country trips to Atlanta and Hartford in weeks 1 and 3, then back-to-back travel weeks to Colorado Springs and Reno. Second half of the season will be much kinder from a travel standpoint. The Broncos will not travel again for a month and will only log 2,934 miles in trips to Laramie and Albuquerque. It will be an exciting second half of the season as you start to see the Mountain West picture. In the Mountain Division, the Broncos sit at 2-1 in league play. The lone unbeaten Mountain Division team is Wyoming, who owns a win over Air Force. In the West Division, Fresno State has rebounded from an 0-3 start to post consecutive wins and leads the West standings. Nevada, San Diego State, and San Jose State are all 1-1. Fresno has another Friday night game this week at UNLV before traveling to Boise. Setting your calendar, the Fresno State game, it is a week from Friday on October 17th. And by typical Bronco game standards, it's an early kickoff at 6 p.m. Friday night on national TV. Start planning now, as this is an Orange Out game in honor of the first Orange Out ever at Albertson Stadium, which was during the 2002 season when Fresno State visited. That's all the time we have this week. Join us again next week as we bring you more Inside Bronco football presented by Ford. I'm Bob Beeler.